In this video, you will learn how to generate this perceptual map or positioning map in Microsoft Excel. I have generated this map using this data, which is the response of the customer about different milk pack brands, which are Halib, Nestle, Nurpur, Olpur, Fresh. These brands are evaluated on three criteria, which is the quality, packaging, and overall acceptability. And the scale 1 to 10 is used for this purpose. 1 shows the lowest number and 10 indicates highest number. So let's learn how to generate this graph using this data. I have already entered the data about the customer response in separate sheet. So firstly, I will go to Insert tab. And in Insert tab, go to this option. And I will select this one, 3D bubble. So I will resize it. Next, right click on this plot area and go to the select data option. Then click on this add and select first brand, which is Halib in series name. In series x-axis value, I want to plot quality on x-axis, packaging on y-axis, and overall acceptability will be indicated by the size of bubble. So I will select in x-axis 4. Then in y-axis, select 8. And in bubble size, select this one. Click on OK. Similarly, click on add again, series name Nestle, series x value is 10, series y value is 10, and series bubble size is, select this cell which is 9. Click on OK. Again click on add button and select third brand. In x axis value 8, y-axis value is 3 and bubble size is 5. Click on OK. Again click on add and enter the information about fourth brand. In x-axis 8, y-axis 8, and bubble size 7. Click on OK and again click on add, and third brand is Fresh, x-axis value is 3, series value is, select this cell, and series bubble size is, select this cell. Click on OK. Then again OK. You can see here that the graph is plotted now, but we have to adjust and make a couple of changes to make it more desirable. I will just resize it some. Now go to this format axis, right click, and here you will find the option of format axis. Remember that we have the criteria 1 to 10, but I have selected 0 to 12 because the bubble area is more, and if I select 10, then it will did not plot it accurately and half bubble will appear on this graph. Minimum value is 0, maximum is 12, that's fine. And in this horizontal axis crosses, I will select this axis value and select 6. Similarly, select this axis and instead of automatic, select this option which is the axis value, and here I will write 6. Now you can see here these values crosses at 6. Now select this axis. And in text option, select no fill. And similarly, select this one and in text option, select no fill. Now go to axis option. And in axis option, go to fill and line option. I want solid line, so I will select solid line here. And color of line is red. Adjust its width. I will select 2 pt. Now scroll down and begin arrow type. I will select this type of arrow and arrow size this one. Similarly, I will select end arrow type like previous one and size will be same like previous one. Now you can see here solid line appeared here with arrows. Now I will select other axis and format like this. Red color 2 pt and begin arrow type this one. Size of arrow this one, end arrow type this one, and end arrow size this one. Now close this. Select chart area, go to plus sign, and here I want to insert data labels, and I want to remove grid lines. Now select this bubble and go to format and from here you can select this design. Similarly, select this one and select this design. For this one, select this bubble and select this design. Select this one and you can select from here. And this is the last bubble. I will select it and from here I will choose the format for it like this. I will format these labels later on. Firstly, I will insert the label here. Go to insert and here you will find the option of text. Click on this down arrow and go to this text box. Right click, go to format shape, no, sorry. And in format shape, go to size and properties and text direction. Here you will find the option. I will want this text direction. So this indicate high quality. You can resize it. Select this and adjust its font size. Bold and 12 and select this shape and in format select shape fill no fill and shape outline no outline. Move this shape and adjust it. Now you can copy this shape. Right click and copy, and I will paste it here. And I will edit it. This indicate low quality. And you can move this shape here. Similarly, I will insert label here on both hand. Go to insert. And in text box, this indicate good packaging. You can adjust it and adjust it font size. Similarly, go to format and select no fill and no outline. Adjust its position. And copy this one. Paste it here. And this axis shows bad packaging. Move this in this position. Now the problem is that if you move this chart, these will not move. So I will firstly group these by holding Control key, select all these. Right click and in group click on this. Now these are grouped together. Now I will change these labels. Select this label, right click, go to format data label and in format data label you will find the option of value from cell. From here you will select the brand which is the Nestle. Click on OK. I will uncheck this Y value and select white color and 14 bold. Similarly, I will select this axis, which is the series of Olpor. Select value from cell and Olpor. Click OK. And uncheck this Y value. Similarly, select this one value from cell. It indicate Halib. Click on OK. And I will uncheck Y value. Similarly, I will select this one. It indicate Noorpur. Values from cell. Noorpur and OK. Uncheck Y value. Select this data label. It is the data label of, you can see here, fresh. Value from cell. Select this cell. Click OK and uncheck Y value. Now select this one data label. and go to format painter and click on here to automatically format it. Similarly, click format painter and click on here. Again, click here and click here. Click here. So one thing, remember that the area should be in square form too. You can also manually adjust this area by going to this format. Select this. And from here you can adjust the area. For example, I am selecting here 4.5. And again 4.5. So you can see here now this area is in square form. But you can move these labels and again group them. So thanks for watching this tutorial. Goodbye.